BN News.
Two officials of the Aquino administration have allegedly received 2 million pesos each from Huweteng Lords. Former Lingayen Dagupan Archbishop Oscar Cruz told the Inquirer that the alleged Huweteng payola against two Aquino administration officials was reported by members of the Krusadang Bayan Laban sa Huweteng, a civil society group against the illegal numbers game. Cruz said he is ready to name the two Aquino administration officials in due time. Cruz also said the illegal numbers game is still rampant in the Visayas and Mindanao. The former Archbishop challenged President Noynoy Aquino to stop Huweteng in line with his campaign promise of a clean government. President Aquino, for his part, challenged Cruz to name the officials who received Huweteng payola and provide concrete evidence to back his claims. And joining us to tell us more about the alleged Huweteng links of two key officials of the Aquino administration is former Lingayen Dagupan Archbishop Oscar Cruz. Good morning, Archbishop, and welcome to ANC.
Good morning, and thank you for having me.
Sir, who are these officials allegedly receiving Huweteng payola?
The debate was taken by the president when I said I'll be willing to name names in the proper forum, etc. And he took it in the sense that I know who these two people are. And I think I'm not the only one who know, because these are not big secrets. And yet, here comes a government with all the intelligence funds, with all the NBI, with all the PNP, and they do not know it. And they would like to know it from me? Come on. Come on. I think we better shape up, no? Or ship out. And I cannot understand this mentality of self-defense by saying you prove it, when in fact you have all you have all the authority and the means to do it yourself. And I'm talking of something that is known to every Tomas, Pedro, and Juan. This is all over town. Mm-hmm. And I hope he would have his cabinet or whatever, the proper entities to do the investigation themselves. And let's see what they find out.
Mm-hmm. Archbishop, based on your own reports or the reports that you received from your group, what is the involvement of these officials? I mean, the extent of their involvement, how is money being transferred to these people?
As a matter of fact, we have traced even the name of someone in government who receives Huweteng payola through a foreign account. Amazing, huh? Amazing. And we who have nothing, we who are nobody, get to know about this. And those in power and means, they don't know anything about it. They remain blessed in their innocence, if not ignorance. If this is the way things are going to be, I think, although I still have hopes for the success of this government, and there is no other way to go about it, I think we should see more in its performance than just rhetoric and appearances now.
Archbishop, you mentioned earlier that this is just a bait, but do you really have any intention to divulge the identities at some forum or venue?
Yes. If he did not say that, I mean to say, that was a calculated statement. I did not say that out of the blue. And that if in the proper forum, I said, if asked, I will name names. I have no problem there because it's common knowledge. And here comes asking me to prove it. As I said, come on, be real, no? Be real.
Mm-hmm. Archbishop, what's your assessment of the Huweteng situation in the country since the new government?
Because it has become, as I said, to the... hold on for a while, I'll just put this off for a while. It is worse than before, because really now, it has become a political monster in the sense that even governors and mayors and barangay captains are are holding on to the lucrative job of being waiting lords, waiting operators, or waiting cobradores themselves. It's very bad.
Based on your expectations of the new government, were you disappointed somehow that this has turned out to be?
Yes, very disappointed. And as I said, I hope I'm wrong. I hope there's still light at the end of the tunnel, and I'm willing to wait. I am not in a hurry. After all, I'm almost a century old fellow, so I can still wait. But of course, there is a limit to that. There is a patience. Patience could also run out, no? No, what I say is not a matter of threat nor a matter of post, etc. I'm just saying, let us be truthful once in a while, no? I think it is good. And now that this is out in the open, let's see what happens next. Because I'm telling you, okay? If waiting is declared illegal, if waiting has now a presidential executive order number so-so with the following penalties of imprisonment and fine, how come waiting is still around? Mm-hmm. At the very tip of the nose of the public authorities concerned in the respective jurisdictions, how come it's still around? And you know what? Side by side with waiting, although it is not no more really our material, we're looking into the drugs, no? Mm-hmm. You know, as usual, the small peddlers are the ones caught. But the big wigs are there having their fine time. But no, we will not deviate on our crusade. But just the same, the matter of drugs is something to be looked into, perhaps by another group, instead of just waiting for others to do the job for them. Perhaps they should assume this matter of facing the drug problem in this country. And when they say that narco-politics has started since May or before May, I am not sure about that, no? Mm-hmm. What I'm just sure is that up to now, the small peddler, the little fellow there are the ones who are brought to jail. The big ones, as usual, the big fish, are out of the net, no?
Yes. Archbishop Cruz, just one more question before we let you go. In case this exposé of yours graduates into some kind of an investigation, would you be willing to testify?
Again, please.
If this becomes a blown-up investigation on wetting, if your exposé will lead to that, would you be willing to testify?
Yes, because we already appeared in the Senate, no? With no lawyers, no security, no nothing. But our own lives, no, on the line. In fact, to the point that even one of our group, one members of our group, was killed. No, that's Boy Morales, Boy Mayor. And you know, up to now it's blank. Exactly, a dysfunctional justice system is what is staring at us. The fellow was killed, and nobody killed him. How nice and how convenient, no? But really, we have no problem there. And I will again gather my key members of the crusade and sit down with the Senate and see. One thing what nice with the Senate is that you have at least immunity from suit, no? Mm-hmm. But let's see what happens next.
Okay, thank you very much, former Lingayen Dagupan Archbishop Oscar.
Thank you, God bless. Bye-bye.
Yes, for sharing with us your thoughts on wet.